that history makes it clear that the legend of fanatical Muslims sweeping across the world, forcing Islam at the point of the sword, is the most fantastic, absurd myth that historians have ever repeated. It is the most absurd myth that historians have ever repeated. And we know from history that we Muslims, we ruled Spain for about 800 years. We did not force anyone at the point of the sword, neither did we do our message, we didn't convey the message. Later on, the Crusaders came, they wiped off the Muslims. There was not a single Muslim who could openly give the Azan. If we wanted, we could have forced everyone to accept Islam at the point of the sword, but we didn't do it. We Muslims, the Arabs, we have been the lord of the Arab lands for the past 1400 years. For a few years, the British came, for a few years, the French came, but overall, we have been the lord of the Arab land for the past 1400 years. Yet today, there are more than 14 million Arabs who are Coptic Christians. Coptic Christian means the Christians in generations. These 14 million Arab Coptic Christians, they are giving Shahada, they are bearing witness that Islam wasn't spared at the point of the sword. We Muslims, we ruled this great country, India, for about 1,000 years, the Mughals. If we wanted, we could have forced every Indian to accept Islam at the point of the sword, but we didn't do it. Today, more than 80% Indians, they are non-Muslims. These 80% non-Muslim Indians, they are giving Shahada, they are bearing witness that Islam wasn't spared at the point of the sword. Today, the country which has the largest population of Muslims in Indonesia, which army went to Indonesia? Which army went to Malaysia, which has more than 50% Muslims? Which army went to the east coast of Africa? Which sword? It is the sword of the intellect. As Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 125. Udu ila sabili rabbika bilhikma wal mu'azzat al-hasna wajadil billati ahsan. Invite all to the way of thy Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching, and argue with them and reason with them in the ways that are best and most gracious. It is the sword of the intellect which is conquering the hearts. It's not the sword of steel. It is the sword of reasoning and understanding which is winning over people. According to an article which came in the Plainsuit magazine, which was repeated in the Reader's Digest Almanac Yearbook 1983, it gave the statistics of the increase in the major world religions in a span of 50 years, from 1934 to 1984. And number one religion which increased the maximum was Islam, 235%. Christianity, only 47%. I'm asking the question, which war took place in the span of 50 years from 1934 to 1984, which forced millions of human beings to accept Islam? Which war? Which sword? It's a sword of intellect, sword of reasoning. Today, according to statistics, the fastest growing religion in America and USA is Islam. The fastest growing religion in Europe is Islam. I'm asking the question, who is forcing these Americans to accept Islam? Who is forcing the Europeans to accept Islam? And when the media says that Islam is subjugating the woman, do you know, out of those people who are accepting Islam in the world, about two-thirds, more than 65%, they are women. More than 65% who are accepting Islam in America, they are women. More than 65% who are accepting Islam in Europe, they are women. I'm asking you the question. If Islam subjugates the woman, then why are the American women accepting Islam? Why are the European women accepting Islam? Why are the Indian women accepting Islam? Why? Because Islam has the solution for the problem of womankind. They have seen the world. When they see the world, they find that Islam is the only solution for the problems of womankind. And today we find, as I mentioned earlier, that there is virulent propaganda about Islam. On the media, we find that they are spreading misconceptions. But the more they're doing that, we find after 9/11, this has reached epidemic levels. Writings against Islam, misconceptions about Islam, the propaganda against Islam increased. But I believe in the verse of the Quran of Surah Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 54, where Allah says, Makruba makrallah wallahu khairul makrin. That they planned and plotted. Allah too planned. Allah is the best of planners. After 9/11, the amount of propaganda they're doing against Islam, do you know, after 9/11, the spread of Islam has increased. Only in a span of 10 months in USA alone, after 9/11, more than 34,000 Americans accepted Islam. In Europe alone, more than 22,000 accepted Islam in 10 months' time after 9/11. And I go to Europe, I go to UK very often, I go to America, and I find that after 9/11, when I give talks, there are more Americans coming for my talk. There are more Europeans coming for my talk. It's good. They want to know what kind of religion is this. Some come to attack, some come to learn. We welcome both of them. We welcome both of them. I like people who attack with reasoning. I love them. And we know Hazrat Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, was one of the staunchest enemies of Islam. And the Prophet prayed for his hidayah, he got hidayah, then he became one of the staunchest supporters of Islam. That is the reason when Muslim youngsters say that death to George Bush, I said, don't say death to George Bush, say, may Allah give hidayah to George Bush. And we find that the more they're attacking Islam, the more Islam is spreading. See, after 9/11, the crowd is increasing even here. And we find even in Bombay, non-Muslims are coming. Previously, we used to give chance to anyone to ask a question. Since the last few years, in my talks, non-Muslim first preference. But the Muslims complain that they never get a chance. And even today, inshallah, the first chance will be non-Muslims only, inshallah. Allah gives the promise in the glorious Quran in no less than 3 different places. In Surah Tawbah, chapter number 9, verse number 33. In Surah Fatah, chapter 48, verse number 28. As well as in Surah Saf, chapter 61, verse number 9. Huwa allazi arsala rasulahu bilhuda wa din al-haq liyuzhira lad-din kulli. Allah has sent his messenger with guidance and the religion of truth so that it will prevail over all the other ways of life, over all the other isms. However much the disbelievers don't like it. Faqafa billahi shahida. And enough is Allah as a witness. This deen, this religion of peace, submitting our will to Almighty God, is the only solution for the problems of humankind. I would like to end my talk with the quotation of the glorious Quran from Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 19, which says, Inna deena indallahi al-Islam. Allah the Creator in the last and final revelation says that Inna deena indallahi al-Islam, the only way of life, the only religion acceptable in the sight of Almighty God is peace acquired by submitting your will to Almighty God. Wa akhra da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.